बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ शौक। शौक इज़ एक्चुअली प्रॉपर मेडिकल प्रॉपर क्लिनिकल कंडीशन इन विच पेशेंट पर्सन सफर्स सीवियरली विद मैनी एबनॉर्मेलिटीज और समटाइम्स इन सीवियर कंडीशन पेशेंट बिकम अनकॉन्शियसनेस अनकॉन्शियस। सो एक्चुअली शौक इज़ नॉट लाइक के जब आपने कोई हैरत अंगेज चीज़ देखी तो एकदम आप शॉक्ड हो गए। सो इट्स अ डिफरेंट, इट्स एक्चुअली अ मेडिकल कंडीशन, इट्स अ प्रॉपर मेडिकल कंडीशन। वी विल डिस्कस ऑल कॉजेज ऑफ शॉक इन आवर टुडेज लेक्चर। वी विल डिस्कस डेफिनेशन ऑफ शॉक एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डिटेल ऑफ हाइपोवोलेमिक शॉक एंड व्हाट विल बी द पॉसिबल symptoms, sign and symptoms of shock, of hypovolemic shock is also included in today's lecture. So let's start our lecture. There are two things in the definition of the shock. First of all, what is a shock? Shock is actually a collapse of circulatory system. Our circulatory system consists of major three components. First of all, our pumping organ, which is actually a heart, and then blood vessels, mean piping in which blood flows, and third one is actually a liquid or a fluid, which is actually a blood. So three components are major components in our circulatory system. So collapse of circulatory system means an disturbance in any component or abnormality in any component which can cause hypoxic condition widespread in the body is known as shock. So collapse of circulatory system is actually failure of circulatory system, is actually failure of normal circulatory system. So if you have studied in your physiology lecture, normal cardiac output our circulatory system have a total blood volume around 5 to 7 liters. So in an average blood is actually a 5 to 7 liters in present in body, and the total capacity of our circulatory system is also 5 to 7 liters. So it doesn't mean कि अगर volume जो है वो 5 to 7 liter है तो capacity 10 liter की होगी. No, our circulatory system is actually typical designed according to our need or according to our circulation volume. So हमारे पास कोई extra space नहीं होती कि extra blood को store किया जा सके. So so capacity is also so our circulatory capacity is also 5 to 7 liter, so which is equal to volume of the which is equal to the blood volume. So what will be the cardiac output? So in 1 minute usually 5 to 7 liter blood moves in our body in 1 minute. So 5 to 7 liter cardiac output is actually 5 to 7 liter per minute. So what will be the possible chances of shock? So first of all, pumping failure. Due to pumping failure or due to any abnormality in the heart, insufficient blood flow to the organs can cause hypoxic condition and can cause generalized death. On the other hand, if there is any abnormality in the blood vessel, it means in any abnormality is present in the piping system of our circulatory system. It can also lead to the shock. And if there is any problem in blood components like blood cells, plasma or electrolytes, so it can also lead to shock condition. So in next slides you will study the possible types of shock. if due to any accident or due to any abnormality, blood volume of blood decreases in our circulatory system, like our body have 5 to 7 liter blood in our circulatory system, but if due to any condition, due to any abnormality, due to any pathology, blood 5 to 7 liter blood become decreases, and usually 3 to 4 liter blood remains in our circulatory system, then there will be a huge chances of hypovolemic shock. Hypovolemic shock is actually a condition in which volume of blood becomes decreases, or volume of any component of the blood decreases. So it is a hypovolemic shock. Another condition is cardiogenic shock, which is associated with the failure of our pumping organ. So actually our pumping organ is heart. So any abnormality in the heart or any disturbance in circulation due to abnormality or due to disease or due to abnormal functioning of heart, it is known as cardiogenic shock. So abnormal blood flow in circulatory system due to failure of pumping organ or heart is cardiogenic shock. On the other hand, if circulatory system or blood vessels and hearts are totally normal, but shock or blood but blood flow is actually slow due to obstruction in the circulatory system. Actually piping is normal, pumping organ is normal, but there is any obstruction is present in the circulatory system, so it may also lead to obstructive shock. So another condition is distributive shock. Distributive shock is in simple wording is actually a disturbance in the blood distribution in the body. In this case, blood volume remain 5 to 7 liter, remain normal range in the circulatory system, but the distribution of blood become damaged, or sometimes distribution becomes slow. So there are many condition in which distributive shock can occur. There is anaphylactic shock, so you can also known as allergic shock, neurogenic shock, and another condition is septic shock. So all types are much important, and we will discuss all types of shock in detail. Let's start hypovolemic shock. What is hypovolemic shock? Hypovolemic shock is actually a disturbance in you can think with the name, which is hypo mean less, and the volemic mean volume. So hypovolemic shock is actually a due to disturbance in the blood flow, disturbance or low blood flow. So disturbance in blood flow can cause hypovolemic shock. Disturbance in blood flow means deficiency of or decrease in volume of blood, which is actually required by our body. So usually when in certain condition volume of blood become damaged in our circulatory system, or volume of blood become low, then body can face hypovolemic shock, because due to low volume of blood our body is unable to fulfill requirements for proper functioning, or oxygen or deficiency due to deficient oxygen in our organs. It can also lead to damage of our organs. So less blood in our circulatory system, or low blood or low volume of blood, can lead to hypovolemic shock. Common causes of hypovolemic shock is the loss of blood, is the loss of electrolytes or fluids, and the loss of plasma. So loss of blood is also known as hemorrhagic shock. What is the loss of blood? You have observed in many cases, like on common cases are road accidents. So loss of blood is actually can cause hemorrhage. So there are two types of loss of blood, like external bleeding in case of common causes are road accidents or any other cause or any damage to your skin or any severe accident to your skin when your blood vessel become ruptured and excessive bleeding occurs due to excessive bleeding or due to external excessive bleeding, a volume of become suddenly drops in our circulatory system. Due to suddenly drops of blood volume in our circulatory system, patient can suffer with sudden hypoxic condition. So when organ suffers with sudden hypoxic condition, patient can undergo unconscious condition. We will discuss symptom of hypovolemic shock in our last slide. So possible causes are GID. Another condition is GID bleeding, movement of if there is any abnormality in the our guts, our intestine, in our gut, then due to any abnormality, bleeding is occurring from our intestine. It is also is an example of external bleeding from our. In this case, due to external bleeding through GIT, it may also lead to decrease in volume of blood or normal volume of blood, which can also cause hypovolemic shock. And other condition is internal bleeding. Sometimes bleeding is not external. Bleeding occurs due to rupturing of any major blood vessel, major blood artery or vein in our body, like in ectopic pregnancy. If ectopic pregnancy is present and blood vessel gets ruptured, then there are huge chances of hypovolemic shock, because due to rupturing of blood vessels, blood moves inside the peritoneum cavity and in blood circulation, and in circulation and in blood vessels, blood volume gets low. So it is known as internal bleeding. In case of hemoperitoneum, due to rupture of any blood vessel in our peritoneum cavity, in our peritoneal cavity, it is known as hemoperitoneum. And due to abnormality or due to rupture of any artery or vein in our thorax region, so it may also be it called hemothorax. So the internal bleeding the internal bleeding is very severe, because sometime internal bleeding, there are very major vessels like arteries, aorta are present in our thorax or peritoneum region. So damage of any major artery or vein can lead to more severe hypovolemic shock, or sometimes it can lead to sudden death, because these are major arteries. Another condition is loss of electrolytes or fluids. In our body, our blood has many components. Electrolytes are major components of our blood. So due to deficiency of electrolytes in our blood, we can suffer with the shock. Why electrolytes become deficient in our blood? You have observed in case of many condition, like severe vomiting, severe diarrhea, sometime patient become unconscious just due to the loss of electrolytes. So loss of electrolyte in case of severe diarrhea and vomiting are common example of loss of electrolytes. It can mainly lead to hypovolemic shock due to decrease in the electrolyte concentration in blood. On the other hand, polyuria, if there is a condition mostly in the diabetic patient, like in patient with uncontrolled diabetic patient, patient in like diabetic, those patient which are suffering with diabetic ketoacidosis usually excretion from the urine become increased. So polyuria may can lead to loss of electrolytes. So it is a condition which can cause hypovolemic shock. On the other hand, excessive sweating nowadays we are suffering with high temperature. So due to excessive sweating or due to dehydration in our body or due to excessive sweating, electrolytes get out of our body, so it can also may lead to shock. On the other hand, SIT is actually an internal loss of electrolyte. In SITs, fluid remain in our body, but electrolytes move out from circulatory system, but fluid gathered in our body, it is known as SIT's condition. In case of acute pancreatitis is a condition in which loss of electrolyte is also present. So the actually loss of electrolyte may lead to decrease in volume of the blood. So decrease in volume of blood may lead to hypovolemic shock. Loss of plasma. There is a condition in which our body suffers with the hypovolemic shock. Like you have already studied in physiology, components of blood like our cells and the plasma. So plasma are actually a component of a blood, most important component of blood. There are many proteins are present in the plasma, there are many factors are present in the plasma. So common condition occurs. So common condition are burn in patient with burn or in a gas formation, plasma become loss. So loss of excess plasma from blood is actually decrease in volume of blood. So another condition is actually exfoliative dermatitis can also cause loss of plasma. So these were common causes of hypovolemic shock. So hypovolemic shock can also lead to sudden death if it remain unnoticed or if it remain untreated for few minutes. So it means normal blood volume in our body is very important. So volume of blood in our body protects us from shock or normal amount of blood or volume of blood also helps in the improvement of our immune system or many other conditions. So these are causes of hypovolemic shock. So I'm going to define hypovolemic shock again. Shock condition due to loss of blood. Trauma is a major cause. Road accident is a major cause in which suddenly blood gets out from blood vessels. It doesn't matter internal bleeding occurs or external bleeding occurs, but if blood loss or any component from the blood get out of blood vessel, it can cause collapse of circulatory system, or due to collapse or failure of normal circulatory system, it can cause hypovolemic shock. So here you can observe some important some important points you can how you can observe hypovolemic shock. A patient with septic shock or a patient with hypovolemic shock difference is mostly difference occurs in the sign and symptom initially. So you with the sign and symptom you can observe के patient जो है वो hypovolemic shock में है या patient को septic shock हुआ है. Of course we have not studied as septic shock, we will discuss later in our slide, but after that you will be able to understand or compare or to you will be able to compare the both condition, hypovolemic shock and the septic shock. So common symptom in if hypovolemia is occurring in body but in mild condition, so headache, fatigue, weakness, nausea, profuse sweating or dizziness may occur. So actually these are mild condition. If these condition persist and they and the show these mild condition remain unnoticed or untreated, then it may lead to severe symptoms. So severe symptoms can also occur suddenly, loss of high blood volume, but it can move from mild to severe. So in case of severe condition, you will observe the patient with hypovolemic shock, cold and clammy skin. It means skin is there will be no fever or pyogenic infection in the patient with hypovolemic shock. So skin will be cold, and due to absence of or due to less amount of blood or volume of blood, skin pale color skin will be observed. So skin will be pale in color. Then rapid shallow breathing due to hypoxic condition, patient will try to inhale more oxygen. So rapid and shallow breathing can occur. Heart rate will be high because of due to low blood volume, pumping of heart gets high because थोड़े time के अंदर उसको जो है blood थोड़े blood को सारी body तक पहुँचाना है. तो blood थोड़ा है तो उसको ज़्यादा pumping करनी है ताकि ज़्यादा blood जाए और ज़्यादा blood वापस आए. So little or no urine output. Sometimes little or no urine output because the patient is suffering from a hypovolemic shock, then there are huge chances of agar hypovolemic ho gaya to urine jo hai formation na ho. Then confusion occurs due to hypoxic condition. Weakness is also present here. Weak pulse become weak, and blue lips and fingernails because due to decrease in volume of blood or due to hypoxic condition. And then loss of consciousness is also a very dangerous condition. If a patient with these symptoms remain untreated immediately or remain unnoticed immediately, it may lead to sudden death. So shock is not actually a very light condition. There are now in even in these in even in this era of technology or medicine, there are many deaths occur in worldwide every year just due to shock. So shock is actually a, and on the other hand, shock, this topic is much important with respect to university. So prepare it and you can ask question anytime. Thank you so much.